Right, Aki Kareem here for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined this afternoon, sorry, by Ben Smith. He's 10-0, hoping to make it. Well, I'm sure he's gonna make it 11-0, November the 11th. And mate, I understand you've been sparring today. How did sparring go?
Yeah, very well. I'm sparring 3 times a week at the moment. We've got all the sparring in the world up at Ben Davidson Performance Centre. So yeah, just knocking down the rounds, putting more rounds in the bank, and yeah, getting better and better. Starting to peak now. It's only 3 weeks away, a bit less now. So yeah, just starting to taper up, sharpen up, and can't wait to get going again. I mean, it'd be 11-0, and then looking to push for titles. So yeah, the training's brilliant, sparring's brilliant. Can't ask for much more.
Well, you're in a gym that obviously has got have had a lot of pedigree go through it and still has a lot of pedigree in it as well, obviously. And so it must attract a lot of top sparring. So is that a bit of a bonus for you being able to have that top quality work there?
100%, 100%. It's not even, it's never a worrying camp, which I've had in past camps, to get sparring in and or have a decent sparring partner with against me. This one, I can't get enough of it. I mean, I'm sparring with Lee Woods, world champions. I mean, there's BJ Saunders is moving me around, even though he's big at the moment, but I'm still learning a hell of a lot of them. And then I've got sparring with I sparred two middleweights today. So I mean, I'm getting a range of sparring in, light, big. I mean, everything. I'm just improving all the time in the gym. Fight night would just be a showcase of where I've got to. But yeah, I'm putting the graft in the gym, and it's brilliant having all these top fighters around me because it's just bringing me on more and more and more.
Well, yeah, I mean, you mentioned Lee Wood, obviously a champion whose footwork is unreal and his punching power goes without saying. Billy Joe Saunders, well, everyone knows about Billy Joe, what a class boxer he is. And actually, so you're sparring Billy Joe as well. So how's he looking as well? And because there's rumors that he's getting back in the gym and everything, yeah.
He's back in the gym. I don't know. I don't want to give too much away. I don't know what Ben and Billy are saying, but he's looking good. He's looking good. He's in the gym every day. He's training. Yeah, and Billy Joe's got class, and the knowledge he has, even just having him in the gym is just. It's just brilliant for any young fighter coming through. And he gives advice as well. And like he did the other day, he gave me, I think it was 10 on the Monday and then 8 on the Wednesday. So, I mean, I did 18 rounds sparring with BJ Saunders and he talked me through it as well. Only stopped the spar halfway through, told me what I was doing right, what I was doing wrong, what I could do better at. I mean, you can't get better than that. I mean, it's a privilege to be around them, and I feel very lucky to be getting advice from somebody like BJ Saunders. And on talking on Lee Wood, I mean, having him around as well, I mean, he's perfect the way how professional he is. I've taken a hell of a lot from him outside of boxing, not necessarily in it as well. But yeah, his diet, and we just touched on it, his punching power. I mean, I've never been in a ring with anyone that hits like him. I mean, it's I was saying, we were talking in the gym the other day, me and Ben were saying, he asked me how hard does he hit, and I said the first bar I had with Lee, I came out and I thought he doesn't hit that hard. I thought I was a bit. I was saying to Barry as well. I was like, he asked me. He went, no, I don't think he. A bit overhyped. I sparred him again about a week later, and he called me for a shot. And yes, he does. And he's one of the biggest hitters I've ever been in with. Having to do body sparring with him as well. I mean, that just toughens me up anyway. But it's good to feel that world class power. What comes down from the top. I mean, there's always talk of it. Obviously, when you're coming through the pros, you always say there's another level of power when it gets up to that world level. And I really do. I felt it with Lee Wood as well. So it's just again more experience. More when I do get to that level, when I do get there, I'm gonna have it all in the bag for, and I know I can do it. So yeah, it's brilliant.
Yeah, someone probably grassed you up for saying he didn't punch hard. That's when he heard about it.
Oh,
He came
yeah,
back the
it was
next.
the biggest mistake I made. I mean, I remember it happened 1 week and I sparred him the week later and Barry asked me again and I just yeah. He can bang. He can bang.
Now, you mentioned that, I mean, these guys, yeah, they've got so much bags of experience. And it's not, as you mentioned very quite rightly, it's not just about what's in the ring, it's about outside the ring, the business of boxing. The politics of boxing, they've seen it all, especially Billy Joe, he's seen it all. So, do they give you those tips as well that about the actual business side of boxing, about the path, about the career? I'm sure Ben does as well.
Yeah, I mean, Barry's my coach, but Barry talks me through it. I trust Barry with 100% of my career, so I kind of leave things like that with him. I know Barry would never jeopardize me in any sort of way. He's with me 100%, so I leave stuff with him. But on what the lads tell me. I mean, Lee Wood has taught me a hell of a lot about nutrition. I lived with Lee for a bit in Harlow. We had a house in Harlow. We lived there for a good part of last year. And what I took off him was just how regimented he is and how organized he is. I mean, it was quite good seeing him lead up to the condom fight, how much of a routine he was in. He never let, say, an interview or some sort of podcast outset him from that. He always was regimentally, I eat this time, I drink this much water this time. And I've taken a lot off him in that sense. And I can remember clearly him saying to me once on the way home from sparring about a tripod. He said, if your water's not and your food's not and your rest aren't working together as a tripod, it's all going to collapse. And that really stuck in my mind. So I've taken that a lot from Lee Wood. I mean, I take a lot of stuff, just a step back and have a look at what they're doing. That's where I learn the most. Say when another one, when Shabazz has got, obviously Shabazz Masood's fighting Jack Bateson, which is a big fight. And then having a look back and watching the tactics, what they're putting towards that and why they're doing it. And there's always a purpose. What I love about this gym, it's not just do this. Don't just throw a jab. You have to have a reason why you throw that jab. What is it setting up? What's next? And it's a thinking process. And I believe I'm a thinking fighter. So, I mean, it works hand in hand with what I want to do. And it's just bringing the best out of me. And I like I said, I'm in the best hands. I'm not worried about that in one shape or other, where my career is. I know Barry's got my best intentions. I've got Lee Eaton and Let's Go Promotions behind me as well. I know they'll give 100% to me as well. So I'm very set in that. And I'm very lucky to have that guidance behind me. So I just keep pushing on now. Keep putting my hard work in the gym. Keep knocking around these top fighters. And they say, if you're knocking around the best, you can become the best. So that's what I'm aiming to be.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I've interviewed Barry before as well, actually. He's been around the game for years, proper old school guy. And he knows his stuff. I mean, it sounds like you've got a great team around you. I mean, you couldn't really have a better team around you.
No, not at all. Not at all. No.
Yeah, you mentioned, before we come and talk about your next fight, you mentioned there another brilliant fight, Shabazz Maverick Masood against Jack Bates. And I cannot wait for that fight because you've got two lads there who, I think they're both unbeaten. They're both good at switching. They're both young. They're both ambitious. They're both considered a big prospect coming forward. I cannot wait for that fight. And I'm finding it hard to split them. I really am. I know Jack very well. Tell me why you think Shabazz wins then, because obviously I know you guys will be behind him.
Well, what I've seen in the gym and the way Shabazz has been performing in sparring, things like that, and what he's been told to do to set Jack up for things, is he's working with it perfectly. He's looking super sharp. And Shabazz has got so much class behind him anyway. His natural ability is through the roof. He's now put, he won't mind me saying this, but the last 6 months, I think he's really, his head's gone screwed down. And he's in this 1,000,000%. He wants this fight badly. He's wanted a big fight for a long time. And now there's a belt on the line, isn't there? Is it WBC?
Yeah.
WBC. Now he's got that there. I mean, you can see there's a huge fire in his belly. He really desperately wants this. And he's always talking about, because there was talks of the fight being in Leeds, and he wasn't even shied away from that. He wants to be the away fight. He's not bothered about that. So, and Shabazz will go out there and do the job. I'm 100% sure of that. But fully behind him. And it's a great fight. Like I've seen Jack obviously fought Ramirez as well, who's a teammate of ours. And I was up there. I went up. It was just me and my dad went out to Leeds and we watched that. It was a tough fight. Obviously Jack won that fight very convincingly. Yeah. But I mean, Ramirez pushed him to the end as well. And I can just see this fight. I can just see Shabazz picking him off until late, and then Jack having to come forward and try and do something very late, which could walk into something. But I think Shabazz is going to get the early rounds. I think that would be the biggest battle for that fight. If whoever can gain the points and get the early round, they won't have to rush after. It'll be a huge boxing chess match sort of thing. So yeah, it'll be a great boxer's watch. I can't wait for it. It's the same night as well. Same night as my fight, which is a bit I'm gutted about, because I would have been desperate to get up there and watch him. But I'll be cheering him on from Grays and Essex anyway.
I can't wait. I'm going to backtrack. It's actually the WBA Intercontinental strap that's on the line. But to be fair, I am going to be in Sheffield for that night to watch that fight. And I wish both of them the best of luck. But your fight on the same night, now that's down south. Tell us about your upcoming fight, mate.
Essex and Grays. It's a Let's Go Management TM14. I believe we're promoting it. It's a get me out, get busy. I broke my hand. It was some sort of a hand injury last fight that I couldn't get over. And I was supposed to fight Conor Marsden for the Summit area. And it got to 2 weeks. I think it was 3 weeks out, and I still hadn't punched in the whole camp. And we were just thinking, is it good? Like, first title, first 10-round fight, is it a good choice? And Barry just said, it's time now. So if he still can't punch, and I couldn't punch for, I think it was 2 weeks after that fight, I started to punch again. So it would have been a very big risk going into that fight. So this fight, that kind of steps us back a track. So it's kind of where we were last fight. We're just going to get another 6-rounder, another 8-rounder, get a journeyman. And then I want to push on to an English or Southern area. Obviously, the Conor Marsden fight fell through and Mark McDonald took my place. And Mark McDonald's going to beat him. So, I mean, that's a fight I want. I want that Southern area. And if there's an English there, happily, of course, I want that too. So, I know Martin. He's a lovely kid, and he's a good boxer. It'd be a tough fight, but I'm 100% fully confident in that fight that I'm going to go and wipe him over for there. I'm not a named person to be calling people out, but that is a big fight that I want, and that's probably what I'm looking for in the next 6 to 8 months. I want a belt. Like I said, I'm 11-0 now. So it's no, I've done all the journeymen. I've done that. I've learned the ropes. I've learned the pro game. Now it's time to push on and be let off the leash in a way. And when I see this, I go back to Shabazz again, but when I see people like that, Shabazz, same age as me, when you see him fighting Jack Bateson and people like that, I want them fights. I want to be in big fights like that too. So, I mean, I'm just pushing towards where my gym mates are going to now. So, yeah, get this fight out of the way. Good, convincing win. Hopefully get that knockout. I'm desperate for it now, but get that knockout. And then if it doesn't come, it doesn't come, but move on to the next fight, and hopefully that'd be Martin McDonagh for the Southern area or someone for the English. I'll take anything. Just want that belt, a belt now. I'm desperate for one.
Well, as you say, you're about that sort of stage now, aren't you? I mean, looking through your record, you fought the regular sort of guys. I mean, you fought some experience of journeyman though, Fons Alexander. I mean, Naeem Ali is really hard to hit. Lee Conley comes forward, he's strong. The vegan warrior he is. And then Jose Bandana, that was like a little bit of a step up because he had 10 wins to his name. But yeah, you are perched now, ready for that breakout. It's good to see that attitude that you actually want to get.
Yeah, I've been wanting to do it for a long time. I mean, it's just this, as you know, boxing's not just what's happened inside those four ropes. Everything's got to go outside. And there's been things at home that stopped me. There's been the pandemic. There's been everything. It's just been so stop-start the last 3 or 4 years, which has been tough. But I've kept my head in the game. I've joined one of the best gyms in the world, in my opinion, and now we're ready to take over. If you said to me 5 years ago, looking back in hindsight now, which I wanted to take a big fight back then or now, I would 100% be now. I'm now 100% ready, and I'm fully confident that I'm going to go and wipe out whatever. I don't know if it's going to be lightweight or super feather, but one of them categories, I'm just going to walk through it, and I'm going to go right to the top, 100%.
You heard the man. I certainly want to get on board with this journey and watch you box, especially now you come across so well and the way you speak. And in fact, a little birdie tells me as well that your record does not do your punching power justice. I know you're 10-0 with no
I mean,
I have heard a few times.
Yeah, I've had fights where I'm supposed to be 8 rounds and then there's been 6 and then it's a 4 and then I've dropped them in the last round and then it's been a rush to get. But I've been looking for it so much. I mean, ever since my fifth fight, I think I've wanted that knockout. So it would be the first 2 rounds. And obviously when the adrenaline's going, I want it so bad. So I'll go out and throw as much as I can, try and knock him out, realise I can't do it, and then just go back to boxing. And it's happened a few times now. But this fight, I'm going to work my way in. This is something me and Barry have been working on in the gym, inspiring bigger guys, getting used to staying a bit closer. That was one of my downfalls, be it my inside work wasn't up to par with what I can do on the outside. So we've been working on that, and hopefully that brings more stoppages. I'll be able to push people a lot more, not give them time when I do hurt them, and feel more comfortable on the inside as well. That's something we have been working on this camp. So hopefully I'll put it to practice on November the 11th, and then yeah, we get that knockout. But if it doesn't come, like it is what it is. I mean, move on, and that English or Southern Arrow title fight is just around the corner. So yeah, that's what we're looking for.
Yeah. I had this exact same conversation with a guy from Manchester called Bradley Ray, who was frustrated that he kept going 40-36, 40-36. Really. And then, and now, if you look at him now, he's absolutely smashing everyone to bits. He just forgot about it and relaxed. And that's what happened.
Same sort of thing happened with Bradley Ski. I remember him coming through and no knockouts whatsoever. And as soon as he hit the level, when they started coming at him, he started picking up knockouts. I mean, You hear it a lot. Like they say, "Oh, he's got not, he ain't got a knockout, he ain't got a knockout." But look at the people I fought. They haven't. They don't get knocked out. And these people that, but that Bandana who I fought last fight. I mean, I hit him with everything, and his face actually changed throughout the fight. And the end of the fight, I thought, I went to Baz. I was like, "There's no chance there was there." He was like, "No, we knew that from the start, but you still tried it." And then I got caught that fight as well, which. Well, I got caught with a big left hook because I left stayed in there too long. So that was a lesson learned. And yeah, we just but this fight, I've just feared something feels different. Something I feel stronger. I feel I'm happier as well. To be honest with you, I mean, like I said, a happy fight is a dangerous fight. But yeah, I feel good, man. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to
All right. Well, it's a good job that you signed with Let's Go Promotions, and isn't it? Let's Go Management.
Yeah.
If you're ready to go, give us your social media handles so people can start following you.
It's B Smith Boxing on Twitter and on Instagram. And yeah, I think yeah, I something I've social media is obviously a part of the game now, isn't it? I mean, you've got to use it as much as possible, which I'm not very good at. So say today sparring, I didn't get any pictures up there. The session was done and stretched out, had a little chat with everyone, and then I wandered out. I remember getting in the car and thinking, oh, God, you've got to start doing it, but. Yeah, the socials, B Smith Boxing is the socials, and yeah, it'd be great to get a bit of following on there now. It'd be good.
Well, it's been great chatting to you, mate. I'm definitely going to be jumping on board on the journey now as well. Make sure you tune in and watch Ben Smith on the 11th of November at the Civic Hall Grays. Get a ticket if you can. If not, you can actually watch it live on YouTube on Into Boxing and Facebook as well. So there we go. You can catch him live. Great speech, mate. Any final shout outs you want to do to anyone?
Yeah, I would like to say thank you to Industrial Solutions, my sponsors. They helped me get through this fight as well. So, like I said, it's a stepping stone fight. So we're not getting big money for this fight, but they're helping us out going through this. And yeah, just a big thank you to them. And yeah, can't wait to get ready on this journey now and get some titles under me. I'm desperate and I want to go right to the top. So yeah, thank you for your time anyway. Thank you.
Oh, good man, mate. Good man. I think people are going to like what they hear, definitely. It's been great speaking to you. Good luck on the 11th, and look forward to
Cheers.
doing it again sometime.